I'm going to introduce you to the Deputy Vice Chancellor, who is going to read extracts from the letter.
Screen the film.
I have never thought that on the 18th of July 2013, I would have to read a letter as follows. We received the letter this morning via email. I read it. The movie is of good report. It's refused classification. I read, and I'll read parts of it, and then we'll have a discussion with the director. Your application for exemption on films for the Durban International Film Festival was received on the 10th of July 2013 by the board and referred to a classification committee on the 15th of July. After having read the synopsis provided, 7 of the films were recommended for classification and the films were referred to the classification committee on the 16th of July 2013, and below was the decision relating to the title of Good Report, our movie for tonight. According to the classification committee, at 28 minutes and 16 seconds, the classification process was stopped based on the fact that the film contained child pornography. According to the Films and Publication Regulation 16.1, if the classification committee discovers child pornography during any classification process, the film game or publication, the classification process shall be stopped. The committee therefore unanimously agreed that this was child pornography and refused classification based on the following scene. I'm at 27 minutes and 35 seconds, Lolita is depicted for the first time in a school uniform in Parker's grade 9 class. In the South African school system, grade 9 includes children aged 14 to 16 years, therefore giving further evidence that Lolita is under 18 years of age. Chapter 4, Section 83A1 of the Film and Publication Act of 1996 as amended stipulates that the classification committee shall in a prescribed manner examine the film referred to it and shall classify the film refused classification if the film contains child pornography, propaganda for war, or incites imminent violence, or at least judged within context. The film is, except with respect to child pornography, bona fide documentary, is of scientific, dramatic, or artistic merit, or is a matter of public interest. They talk about the definition of child pornography, and we're going to engage with the directors and people involved with the movie, and they go on as to why it's not allowed. I then continue and go and read another extract for you. From the above, it is clearly depicted that a minor has engaged in sexual conduct with an older male and has participated during the sexual conduct, therefore 1 and 2 of the definition of child porn on paragraph number 4 applies to this film. This movie has therefore been refused classification and all copies must be either surrendered to the police or destroyed.
What?
In terms of the Films Publication Act 1996, the possession and distribution of child pornography are criminal offences. You may appeal this decision to the Film and Publications Appeals Tribunal. If you intend to appeal, you are required to lodge the completed appeal to the board within 30 days from date hereof, together with the applicable fee. University of KwaZulu-Natal, we have no doubt that we will appeal this decision. You as the audience engage with the director and people of his team. My life's work is in the area of sexuality as a professor, but I am at this point in time not going to comment on the content of the movie. I haven't seen the movie. I've read what they have said to us, and we need to engage. We need to engage with it at this point in time today because of the fact that we are not allowed to see it. I couldn't watch the movie to make an informed decision. Thank you. And we apologize to the audience, but we thought that we will bring you here tonight and then engage with the issue. We've also made a decision that we will not screen another movie because it would just not be respectful to the directors and everybody involved.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Luazi Manzi. I am Jamel's wife, the director of this film. I am one of the executive producers of this project. I am also a doctor. I'm a medical doctor. I graduated from the University of Cape Town in 2006. I am currently working at New Somerset Hospital in Greenpoint in Cape Town at the emergency unit. The subject matter that has been covered in this film is something that I see every single day. If we are going to be censored, then I suggest that the ministers of education, that our president, that all the people that are involved in the schooling system, that all the people that are involved in the social welfare of our youth also be banned and be censored. Just because they don't want to see it, it doesn't mean it's not happening. I see it happen every single day. You can have your 16 days of activism, you can have your day of HIV awareness on the 1st of December, you can have your Women's Day, you can have your Youth Day, but these things are happening every single day. When you go home after your 16 days of activism, I am there at 12:30 in the evening in the casualty unit while a 14-year-old is busy having a miscarriage and bleeding to death. When your day, when your 1st of December is over and you've had your expensive conference and you've eaten and you've drank and everybody's talking about how HIV/AIDS is spreading and how our youth is not listening, I am there at 4:00 in the morning with a 13-year-old who has somehow managed to get themselves to the hospital asking if they can have an abortion at 3:00 in the morning. I am there every single day. It happens every single day. We shall not talk about it. We will talk about it. You will see it. And we will engage in this conversation. Obviously think you are 14, so well done. 3 years old. To my husband, I am very proud of the projects that you have put together. They will see it, don't worry. And to the cast and crew of
Malcolm, I don't want them to see it.
Guys, you have done a sterling job. Well done. This is an absolutely pivotal day in the history of filmmaking in South Africa. This will resonate well into the future as a very important film in the history of filmmaking in South Africa. My husband doesn't wish to speak anymore. I have spoken for him, and I hope that what I have said tonight will be able to open you guys up for further dialogue for the rest of the evening. Thank you very much.